I'm so excited about this book. It's so sweet. It's a story that can be read to any age group, from older boys and girls to the littlest ones. You can gather families together because it's about interesting points in our country. And before I had ever gone to Washington, D.C., I didn't even realize that these memorials and monuments and moments, poignant moments, that are captured in these museums from our country's history existed. And we have brought them together in a really fun, concise way that follows our family and what we did while we were in Washington, D.C. In 2006, my husband was coaching for the Nationals. And while he was there, I was very deliberate and intentional about bringing our family out into the Capitol every single day because there's so much to see and I wanted to make the most of every moment. And my kids were really amazed by what was out there and we had a lot of fun in this journey. So what I've done in this book is I've tried my very best to simulate our family experiences, at least some of them, while we were in our nation's capital. And it's funny because there's a lot of humor when you're doing life with kids no matter where you go. It's engaging. There's a treasure hunt the same way there was in our first book. You know, on every page in Katie and Addie with JD Love Christmas, you could see a train. Well, in this book, you can search for a flying object. There may be an airplane or a helicopter or a balloon because there's all sorts of the things that are flying around the city. And so it's kind of a fun way for boys to be able to go and look for what is found on every page. But there is a very historical documentation of what happens in our country's history that's recorded in this book as well, and in world history for that matter, and real opportunities for parents and children to be able to dialogue about historical references that they may or may not ever get to learn about in school, that may or may not have ever been brought up in a classroom context. So I'm hoping to really be able to connect parents and children in this book and every page to be an adventure and to help think a new thought and to spark a new understanding of the rare privilege of what it means to be uniquely American. I got the idea for this particular book, oddly enough, from my publisher. Katie and Addie with JD Loves Washington, D.C. was not an original concept title. Our publisher said, "What about if one of the journeys that you wrote about was your time in Washington, D.C.?" And I thought, that would be amazing. I loved our time in the Capitol. So something really interesting that I did during the time that we spent in Washington, D.C. is I required my kids to journal every single solitary day. And I made these little spiral notebooks and they were color-coded and I would put the topic at the top of every page. And then Katie and Addie at that time, sometimes the words they couldn't even write, they would draw pictures, but they documented every single day that we spent in Washington, D.C. in the summer of 2006. So when my publisher came to me about this title, we went back through the journals and began to look at what we did every day and how the kids really felt about it and what their experiences really were so that we could be authentic in producing this book in a way that really reflected our family and would inspire and encourage other families to want to take their kids into a city that might be somewhat daunting when you think of memorials and monuments and museums. You don't think, wow, that would be a great family vacation. So when my publisher gave me the idea of this book, I thought, you know what? Those were some of the sweetest times that we spent as a family. So when he sparked the idea, I used the references that we had from our family experiences and I ran with it. What I'm hoping to achieve with this book is to really bring an incredible perspective of the blessing of being American. When I travel the world, which I got to do with my father, he's retired U.S. Air Force, and I got to live all over the world, I was able to see firsthand the blessing of our nation. And what I have seen in the last decade or so is a lot of heartache and hardship with being American. And possibly the perspective might be somewhat tarnished of the real blessing of our nation and the roots of our heritage. I wanted to be able to help young children be proud of where they come from, and also to understand our roots, to understand our heritage. Because of my husband's career in Major League Baseball, I have been able to travel every corner of our nation. I don't think off the top of my head, but minus Alaska, there's just a couple of states in there that I have not actually put my foot on, driven across, stopped, you know, seen a big landmark. And one of the things that I had never done was travel to our nation's capital. And I was amazed when my husband got the job to be able to coach the Washington Nationals. I could not believe what Washington, D.C. held. And what I had seen in Europe when I was traveling with my father and all the magnificent cathedrals and all the amazing buildings, they are right there in our nation's capital. And I wanted to awaken the sense that we have such a treasure. Some people don't even understand the beauty and the magnificence that is found in our nation's capital. So I wanted to inspire people to go there. Honestly, I feel like every American should be born with a stamp on their passport required to go to Washington, D.C. So I wanted to spark that inspiration. But secondly, this is a political season in our country right now. And sometimes in the political rhetoric, the back and forth, it's not always very positive. And our nation is a positive place. We are a beacon of light for the world. And so I wanted children and parents and family to be reminded it's an amazing blessing to be an American, even in a season and a climate that might feel more burdensome and more encumbersome. I wanted the blessing to feel light. And then finally, with writing this book, what I really wanted to accomplish is I wanted our kids to be able to see that we have a uniquely biblical root and foundation. We really are one nation under God, and there are so many references to that in our nation's capital about the religious freedoms that our forefathers really desired for each of us to have, about the way they wanted us to be able to pray, and the way they wanted us to be able to express ourselves openly about our faith in God in this country. And those are real roots, somewhat tarnished and sometimes covered up. But they are really there, and we have grown to be who we are today because of that blessing of what they fought for in the beginning, that's symbolized on almost every street corner of Washington, D.C. So while this book is fun and I wanted parents to be able to read something easy and effortless and bring boys and girls and little ones and older ones and just get book time and story time done at bedtime, I wanted to ignite and inspire and encourage our country in this next generation of amazing young patriots that await us.